New Year's Eve, excuse me? It's already New Year's. I mean, let's be real. This game actually did happen last year on New Year's Eve. And I know, like, I'm literally behind off the real life NBA and in my career. And this game just happened just recently, well, last year. And the Thunder beat the Mavs. And of course, rocking my colorways, the blue lips, I call them. And I'm pretty sure the Mavs did wear these jerseys when they lost against the Thunder. And plus, as a film, this Happy New Year to everyone out there. First video of the new year and the new decade, 2020. Damn, that's a way to start off for the Thunder. First spot is in Lob City. You wait in LA. Oh. Oh, what? What? That's a block. Let the boys play. Oh, come on. Shoot or shoot. To the paint, here's Adams. Pops in the layup for two. Adams has got his second bucket of the game to go. Steven Adams, a workhorse down low like that. Once he's got position, he'll want the ball. And Chris Paul picks up the foul. That's his first foul. And that's a quick foul for him there. Looks like the refs are going to call this one pretty close. Why can't I make the shots? That's bullshit. Excuse me, we're on an 8-0 run. Chris, can you go down and get your ankles breaking? You're old and you're washed. Okay, he may not be that washed, but come on. Yes! Get him out of here. That's a whistle. He did not want to hear his second foul, and we're not even out of the first quarter. Shaq Gilgeous Alexander, check in with the first ball. And in every season, the Thunder continue to be one of the more dominating teams on the way. Just wonder how much Steven Adams has been the catalyst for that kind of mentality. We know that offensively, he's always in there to grab rebounds, but it's part of what they know is important.
Finally, we're in the bucket.
Is collecting the ball. At this point, you might as well go ahead and chalk up the points when he's at the free throw line. Pretty much automatic.
Yes, Donator.
Shai Gilgeous-Alexander, he's been killing for the Thunder. I see a few highlights of him. Didn't he get a game winner?
From deep three-point range, Oklahoma City the rebound. That's the leader.
Of course, we can't stop Adams.
Aminari right side, second chance effort. Not gonna go that time. Nice team from Porzingis. Here's Doncic.
You can't make anything.
Now here's Hardaway. He's averaging just around 8.5 points a game.
Gilgeous Alexander pulls it in. 0-5. But they can't miss a thing. It's just a warm-up for the new year. Are you kidding me? It's going to be like this in real life. Really pretty much dream of.
First quarter of action, just under 3.5 minutes played. Right side, Hardaway. No good with the elbow jump. And so it's Gallinari with it. They'll bring it up with a Thunder. And there's the pass to Nader.
I haven't even shot from the field yet. There we go, finally. Four time is the charm. And then one.
7 points in the game.
So many different offenses that Tim Hardaway Jr. has played in, and he's trying to improve in his on-court awareness. A good show of it there.
Now, here's Gilgeous Alexander. He's coming off a 13-point game against Toronto. Gallinari down low. He's against Porzingis. And it's Gallinari missing.
Well, he's just really struggling right now. Everything he's throwing up, nothing really helping out in terms of his confidence. I mean, these ones aren't even close.
Oklahoma City leading by 6. Takes a shot at the elbow. A rebound by Marjanovic.
And when you can't get anything to fall, it definitely
why?
Gets in your head. Especially if you're a player.
I make those.
A lot of shot attempts, but otherwise, the mindset is, I just got to get the next.
That's bullshit.
Goal. And you don't want to put that much pressure on yourself.
Last season, a bit of a renaissance for Gallinari.
And the way Gallinari stepped up last season, Kevin, was a big reason the Clippers were as strong as they were. Now, on the other side of 30, he's been playing some of his best basketball here at Blake.
Fires the three, hits the three-pointer to fall.
Great quarter for his, at the offense.
I have 10 of our points, team. There you go. Somebody finally scored. It's Luka.
Beautiful job closing the gap here. Let's see if they can sustain this run.
Well, they've shown both effort and will to get back into this one, but can they finish this one off? Can't let up now.
So here's Gallinari after Luka Doncic's bucket. Adams finds Roberson.
And I said Roberson hit that. He airballs the jump shot. Thank you.
And now a chance to honor a player who has been on fire.
Has Roberson played this season for the Thunder? And is he even still on the team? I don't think he is. He might be still on the Thunder's team, but I don't think I've ever seen him play yet. I don't think I see him played at all last season. I like how I said a good shot contest, even though I played some pretty weak defense.
Shot. High arcing shot.
No, but that's a defensive breakdown. Okay.
And the Thunder lead by three.
Gilgeous Alexander comes at you in a lot of ways. There's floaters and pull-ups and drives.
Tie game.
Offensive player.
Traps in the train. Nothing better than a hustle play, Mike, that it gets the whole team amped up. Sets the example for everyone. Robinson the pass to Adams.
Dude, this guy is killing it. Weird, I'm the only starter out there for the Mavs. He airballed that.
And a quick look now at the best free throw shooting team.
And I think and it gave me the offensive board.
Careless when you play them. I mean, no wasted opportunity.
At least he didn't give me a turnover for that.
Schroeder, right side. It's deflected. Pass break, Dallas. Murray with the ball.
Murray! I can see why you don't get playing time.
Well, an interesting part of this trade is I think Sam Presti thinking about the potential of Gilgeous Alexander and what he can do in Oklahoma City. Had a very, very good season for Doc Rivers as a rookie.
Damn, two fouls. I like the part out they're still keeping me in there.
With the rebound, they're getting their first look at the Thunder.
This is the first of three games these two teams will play against one another this season.
Now here's
what the hell was that?
No points in the game hit for him. So the wing on the left, six to shoot to the middle.
Oh, let's go home. That was just
I had Galley on me.
I do not remember the last time I saw a dunk like that in a game. Now here's Schroeder. A 23-point game for him in the win against the Raptors in Toronto. Fires from deep.
Dial.
And that one is hammered home.
Am I going to Scala?
I agree, and that's nothing new coming from him, GA. He loves going to work on the rebounding, going to work on the board.
Stick with fundamentals there. Shot goes up.
Oh, come on.
This is fifth, 8-minute field goal. Gilgeous Alexander surveying the deep. And it's Schroeder missing. Dallas shooting 25% for the fielder. Powell with the bounce pass. Somebody's catching here by Dallas. To the inside. Outside for Murray.
Murray, you gotta make those. Also, I'm putting your minutes to zero.
Gilgeous Alexander passes to Schroeder. To Gilgeous Alexander. And change shot. And two shots coming up at the line as he gets fouled on the shot.
Oh, I'm going to be on the bench. That's our game, though.
Well, when Nerlens Noel stays
literally
confident offensively, good things like this tend to happen. It's been up and down the last few years for Nerlens Noel, but there are still some impactful numbers for the minute.
It's a completely new group on the floor for the Mavericks.
Up by four.
And for Noel, his numbers will never match the visual impact.
We got the starters, well, except for Barea.
A player about the little things out there, just being a rim protector, making sure the guys think about him when they're attacking the rim.
On the court for the Mavericks.
And he missed it.
The incredible forward pair. Then there's J.J. Barea. Then there's Marjanovic. Here's Paul.
No, you're not, Chris.
Takes it the other way.
Roberson has four fouls. That's three games in a row I've missed a free throw. What's up with that?
Players have to reset quickly with 14 on the clock, and I think coaches are starting to think about how it is they might have quick sets as opposed to getting the ball to the top of the key and trying to run through a traditional set. Maybe you have quick sets after the reset to get yourself a better shot.
Stretch. Now, Gilgeous Alexander. He has six. That's at five from 18. This is that one. He's made one and missed two.
JJ, I see you.
Boban. He hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points. Marjanovic has got the lead up to seven now for the Mavs.
And those second chance points really become almost like bonus points when you can get them.
Paul against Boran. And again, no good by Oklahoma City.
There we go, JJ.
A bit off on that one.
2 points, that one goes.
And they keep hammering away out of inside, forcing the ball into the paint.
Guys are looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a
hold on. I had to sneeze.
Okay, what's going on today? Oh, we're trying for it from the sideline.
Well, Kevin, the last season, the G League tested out an expansion of the Clear Pathway. Now that expansion is making its way to the NBA. Should discourage those intentional fouls that slow up teams on the fast break. Fans wanted it, and analysts clamored for it. That would allow the amazing athletes in this league more opportunities to show what they can do on the fast break.
You're right, David. Welcome, change. Thank you.
There's such leadership that Chris Paul brings every night to the floor. For the enjoyed respect and the opponent's respect.
Chris Paul's only 2 of 7.
He's making everyone around him better right now.
Good on goal. Mavericks leading by 5. Passes to Barea. A 3. A new 14 for the Mavericks. And Gilgeous Alexander's got the ball here for the Oklahoma City Thunder. Pass to Noel. Sickers with the steal.
I got blocked because I thought Luka was going to, I was going to call a lock to Luka, but he stopped.
And a wide open shot from Paul. And again, no good by Oklahoma City.
No doubt he's struggling right now from the field. Let's see if he can get it.
I'll take this.
Count that one.
No doubt about the consistency when it comes to scoring on the basketball for him tonight. A real nice lift for their offense.
Six on the shot clock. Happy to see that one going at missing 6 of his 9 shots today.
Said it time and time again, Chris Paul in the mid-range is pretty much half the time going to be good.
Deep connects from 3-point range. 27 points for him.
And let's see, guys, if that triggers another
a gold rain extender. That's right.
Him after hitting 3 triples in that first quarter.
From the baseline. Again, the miss by Paul.
Maybe there are ways to contribute that don't involve shooting the basketball. That's the best way. Maybe he can help them out trying to win this game.
Oh, JJ. You're disappointing me.
Why still? I expect him to make one of those.
Here's Nader. He had 13 points in the win against the Raptors in July. Porzingis with the steal. Doncic outside.
Look, the magic.
That one
Not really. Up by 10. Seth? Oh, Seth. He got robbed.
And here comes the break. Here's Nader. He nails the 16-footer. Nader's got five.
Can't talk enough about the subtleties in that setup right there. The assist, really the key to that entire sequence.
Now the dish to Powell.
I tried to juke, but no, I don't know what I went for. Did it just give me hold the ball too long?
Here's Gilgeous Alexander. Porzingis with the block.
You can see Porzingis taking some pride right now on the defensive end of the floor, taking care of the shooter with his long wingspan that time.
So for Dallas, their last game will end against the Lakers in Los Angeles. Inside. Terrific assist. A nice finish. Solid play all around.
And Chris Paul at his best right there on that kind of play. A legendary distributor who spots the open man.
There's the pass to Doncic. Porzingis at the elbow. Curry on the wing.
Seth.
Time off the rim as that one falls. Curry's got the lead up to 10 now for the Mavs. Passes it to Adams. All against Curry.
That's a fucking illegal screen.
Nice pass in my elbow city. Here's Gilgeous Alexander. Powell pulls it in.
So weird. Sometimes when you get that much time, it can throw you off just as much as having no time.
Outside. Down to five on the shot clock. Shot from free throw range. That shot off.
Oh, that should have been a steal.
Here's Nate. He has five. He feeds it to Muscala. Over for Zingas. Shot is good.
He got that. Muscala, what can do that in LA?
That's a staple of his offensive attack, and proving once again he can do some damage from that area.
And so it's the Dallas Mavericks.
They're up by 8, though.
Up 8 points at the end of the quarter. Their defense has been terrific in this game. And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Kevin, thanks. New Orleans, you guys had a tough time stopping their offense in the first half. What do you have to do differently?
We got to protect the paint. They can't race in any easy baskets. You know, that's up to communication on front of the post. You know, it's a real thing, a lot more.
We'll see if those changes stick. Thanks for your time. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, thank
Man, why are you interviewing Noel? Why can't you just interview me? We're literally up by 8. And I have 29 points in the first half. Doesn't make any sense.
And we're getting back to the action in our New Year's Eve broadcast. Dallas leading by 8. Gallinari and Adams, the combo on front. Chris Paul is out there with Dennis Schroeder, and it's Nader in its small forward. That's the lineup in the game for Oklahoma City.
This is why I love his game. You really have to admire his tenacity.
Damn, Gallinari.
A heady play there from Schroeder, sipping the pass to the team.
He was a part of that Paul George trade, wasn't he?
Here's the three. It's rebounded by Oklahoma City. Adams finds Gallinari. Schroeder with the ball.
Oh, Gallinari, he's got the first 5 points.
And that 3-ball from Gallo looks good at just very impressive form right there.
Danilo Gallinari, here in the NBA draft, he was just a catch-and-shoot type player. But he's so much more than that now.
But I think with the way the...
But I got the first 6 points.
Gallinari's ability to do that, he's gotten a lot smarter about picking his spots when the pump fake can drive in and draw some contact.
Oh, you bastard. That's dumb. Oh my god, I'm in there. Zion, Donovan Mitchell, who was the other one? Miles Bridges? I forgot who the other one was. Was it Derrick Jones Jr.? Oh, come on. Gally's got the hot hand. Gallinari's got the hot hand. Did his sub Chris Paul and who was the other guy? Nader? I mean, Robertson is the starter. But still, the third quarter just started.
So valuable when he's out there on a consistent basis. And he can score from anywhere on the floor.
Back to Porzingis. And the top by Porzingis.
Porzingis finishing strong that time. No doubt about that one.
We're trailing by 8. Adams outside.
He's going to be shaking his head on that one. No, he missed an easy one.
Yeah, you can't make them all, and you for sure you want him taking that kind of shot.
Here's Porzingis, and it's Dallas with another.
Yeah, they've only missed one out of their first 5 shots here in the second half.
Oh, that was Porzingis' first points of the game.
Shooting looks to be great rhythm.
His first 4 points. I had to get him involved.
Marjanovic gets going up. Find the shoot. Here's Nader. Porzingis with the block.
Nice defense, boys.
And some changes here for the Mavericks. Maxi Kleber comes in for Marjanovic. And it's right in for Hardaway. Doncic kicks to Porzingis. To the middle. And he takes the feed in stride and slides it home.
And there is no better way to add to the lead.
In that jersey, especially when the slam is coming from the point guard.
Oh, yeah, his teammates love.
What? That should have been a steal.
I'm sure he's going to hear about it when he gets to the huddle.
And the call on the shot sends him to the line. Greg, last season, Dennis Schroeder transitioning to more of a 6-man role with the Thunder.
Oh, he missed it.
Looked really good. He's always been able to score and create. And coming off the bench might be the best spot for him.
Murray's checked in for Luka Doncic.
The potential Schroeder has is pretty exciting. Such a lightning quick point guard.
Wide open look here for Murray.
Murray.
You're trailing by 11.
You're embarrassing me, bro. Why are you on the team when you don't even know how to make a shot?
Headshot off.
Well, he had the perfect opportunity to finish that one, guys, and just flat out blew it.
Here's Murray.
You're gone. I'm putting your minutes to 0.
This much of a struggle from the field to still have the lead shows how
he's 1 of 6. He actually made one when I was on the bench. I'm putting your minutes straight to 0. How about that? How does that feel?
Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot 2 free throws.
Can't wait to manage my players' minutes so I can just put Murray's straight up minutes to 0.
You're going to be one of the elites in this league.
Noel's checked in for the Thunder. And Dallas with a change here to Jalen Brunson. He's checked in for Murray. Thunder have gone even 50% from the floor here in the third quarter. 4 of 8. Gallinari on the wing. Again, the upper score.
Are we sure that's the same player, guys? He looks completely different. What confidence he's playing with, and look how engaged he is on both ends.
Kleba, the pass to Brunson. And he takes that one up and powers it through.
And there is no better way to add to the lead.
In that third GA, especially when the slam is coming from the point guard.
Oh, yeah, his teammates love that one. I'm sure he's going to hear about it when he gets to the huddle.
Here's Adams.
So he got presented with the pump fake.
That one misses.
Damn.
Well, Steven Adams still working on becoming
my big off the bench have like more consistent free throw multiple fouls.
Another opportunity upcoming.
We're getting boxed out by Steven Adams.
Not the best statistic for him in terms of his performance at the line. Very low numbers.
Oh, you missed them both.
Missing both.
And you look at the way Steven Adams has developed his offense the last few years, and it's been a huge boost for this team. He has always been a great defender, but now
yikes. He's
an important cog on this team in terms of scoring.
Here's Schroeder. An amazing finish with a hand right in his face. Schroeder's got 5 points now this quarter. In the corner, right with it. Lock at six. In the corner, it's Kleba.
Yikes!
The
hell was that?
You forget how young he is.
Okay, they're coming back.
Alexander's checked in for Noel. The Mavericks also with the sub.
Oh, no.
And her pass is to Bellinari.
A weak shot of here.
The Thunder able to retain possession. And the Thunder making a change here. Muscala's checked in. A three off the inbound. And it's Schroeder missing. Mavericks leading by 7. Pass to Brunson.
No!
Down low.
Oh, nice steal.
And stolen by Wright.
Oh, come on!
And again, Dallas turns it over.
What is going on? What is going on in this ball game? Did I just get posterized by Andre Roberson? And when the hell could Andre Roberson do that? I don't think I've ever seen him do that in real life. All he does is airball shit. That's it. He has Hall of Fame airball. Alright, bet. Bet.
Big help on that alley-oop.
Bet.
Dallas has gone 2 of 5 with a 3-point shot since coming out of the break. And that's out of bounds. Dallas will retain possession.
Oh, great. Lost my takeover. And watch, they come back.
Tough last year for Robertson with the knee.
Never mind. Thank you so much.
He's a defensive staple.
No, no, no. Bring back Roberson's airballing ass at back out here. I can say ass, but I can't cuss.
That's good from Gilgeous Alexander. And with Robertson,
get him back out here.
Last year was definitely felt.
Yeah, it hurt the starting lineup and some of the balance that they had established for the last 3 or 4 seasons with Robertson in the lineup. Raises the level of that defensive intensity on a nightly basis.
On the court for the Mavericks.
Dwight Powell is out there with Luka Doncic. Then there's Hardaway.
I was playing great defense, and they call it defensive breakdown. That's some bullshit. That's some straight bullshit. And they call defensive breakdown that? Huh? Where's the illegal pick? A steal.
Jackson with three. Mavericks with the rebound. Powell's got his fourth rebound in this one.
Yeah, the three-pointer has not been his.
He just lob-tipped it. He just lob-tipped it.
Well, that just scrambled the defense all kinds of ways with that great initial pass.
Come on, should be dunking them fools.
And we're about 3.5 minutes into the fourth quarter.
Get out of here.
Leading by 18. Let's the three fly. Sinks the three-pointer. He's got 44.
And perimeter scoring, I have to imagine it was a topic of discussion at halftime.
Maybe trying to find a little bit more space and ball movement to get guys open at the three-point line.
To end the run.
I got more rebounds than assists.
Now the Mavericks take it the other way. Here's Hardaway. Evans has got rebound number 15 here tonight.
And what's sad, I can't even get a triple-double.
Here's Nader. From 13, the Thunder with another miss.
Nobody getting a hand in his face in that painted area. The miss he's going to be disappointed with.
Play the lower seeds. You think the NBA should go down that road?
I think the consideration will still be there. I think that conversation is going to happen over the course of the next 2 or 3 years. I don't see it changing in that time, Kevin, but it's healthy to continue the dialogue to the point where maybe we do get it.
Six to shoot. Adams got one.
That's 3 seconds.
It's scored by Marjanovic. Out of bounds. Oklahoma City takes possession. Oklahoma City has gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. Gildas Alexander passes the ball. And a quick assist by Gildas Alexander as that one goes in.
Nice job catch and shoot there. Chris Paul making it look simple and caught the defense a little bit out of position.
In the corner, Marjanovic with it.
Oh.
Side off the mark. And Gildas Alexander's got the ball here for the Thunder. Over in the corner, Paul. A floater, and that's 2 points on the way. Paul's got 8 points in the quarter.
Well, the deft touch from Chris Paul on the floater there. His timing on those shots sublime.
Knocked away.
Excuse me?
Taken away by Paul. That one goes in. Paul's got 22 points.
Okay, bet. Right, I don't have to worry about Andre Roberson. I'm worried for Chris Paul.
And so it's Dallas with it. They lead by seven.
Yeah, come back to this like you did in real life.
They get a hand on it.
What are you doing? Give me that.
This ball grabs the miss. Oklahoma City shooting.
I'm trying to call screens, Chris. You're going to lose this game no matter what.
That one is good. He's only missed one shot of his six taken on the floor.
Adams just continuing to grind it out. Outstanding, staying after that possession.
Oh, pussy.
And Adams sends it down. And out of bounds as the Thunder gain possession. And a quick look at how the Oklahoma City Thunder's schedule is shaping up. On Thursday, they'll be matching up against DeMar DeRozan.
and the San Antonio Spurs. And then on Saturday,
Super T, you're not coming back like you did in real life.
And looking at that Nets matchup, it's the second game of a back-to-back, and you know they're going to be feeling the effects of it. Playing that much basketball in that short amount of time really takes a toll.
On the clock, here's Adams. There's Noel. And no good. Ice D from Porzingis. Trying to get something going. The rebound by Steven Adams.
Oh, great. My teammate grade's going down.
Rebound here tonight, all over the place. Here's Gildas Alexander. They get it back. Nader gets the ball. Fires the three.
Okay, Chris. This is where Chris Paul lights it up like he did in real life.
Solution to ending this run, it would just be getting back and actually playing some defense.
And the Mavericks call time here.
Giving up a run here. Can they turn it around?
Hard to say right now. At this point, I see the coaches run through two or three iterations of defense. Is there a fourth? I'm not sure.
And now, we'll have to take a look at our Jordan player of the game.
And it's been a ridiculous performance in the best sense possible. I mean, everything about his game has been working. And no matter what they've thrown at him, he's had the answer.
Well, to come in here facing a hostile crowd and have a game like he's had, that's what separates the good players from the crowd.
What are we doing?
And you look for why they keep giving up buckets here. And they're boxing out for lack of boxing out. It's really hurting them.
The best of Porzingis. Here's Doncic. The rejection by Paul. Dallas needs to get off a shot.
Thank you, Luka.
Gets it to go. And the Mavericks lead by 12.
And he is starting to turn it on now after that slow start.
That's a two from Paul. Misses off the left eye. The Mavericks have gone 7-16 to the field here in the fourth. That's about 43%. Looking to get it going.
Oh, when?
Out there to play defense. He excels.
Damn.
Off the ground.
Gets
so
fouled.
To get the block.
Oh, Roberson's back in. Oh, great, great. Can't wait to dunk on his butt in the next 3 minutes.
And the first one drops.
And as Dirk Nowitzki walks off into the sunset, the Mavericks seem to have found their next European superstar in Luka Doncic.
Poor Tim, he's cold. I'm gonna guard Roberson because he dunked on me.
Coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
this team will determine his future with the franchise.
Well, this team has never missed the playoffs under his watch, and the interesting thing with the massive trades that happened in the offseason, how much Billy Donovan gets the opportunity now to teach and coach this group of players.
1:41 left here in the fourth quarter. Ball outside, just fine to shoot.
Wow.
Paul's got 27 points.
Chris Paul tapping into that absolute best magic tonight. For a long time, he set the standard for point guard play in the NBA.
Marjanovic passes to Hardaway. Doncic dishes to Hardaway. Pass to Doncic. Let's go. And no good that time. And it's Oklahoma City the other way.
And so just rolling to the finish line now.
Damn.
A very impressive performance for Dallas.
You know, it's tough to put your finger on the...
Oh, I didn't even get my tenth rebound. Oh, well. Oh, well. Well, it's turnaround first play. Then it didn't happen in real life. The Mavericks take the Thunder out. I don't know how you say this, but I'm just going to cut it like this. Damn, the gameplay, the crowd is just silent.
He's perfect from the line.
You can just literally hear like a cricket. Besides, you can hear just maybe see, but still. Let's turn around his fair play like how it was in real life. The Mavericks take the W in Oklahoma City.
I guess they don't need home cooking to feel at home. I mean, Kevin, just a masterful performance all the way around. Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Greg Anthony.
That's the beauty of this team, man. We try to never let up. And part of that, that's coach. He's always preaching, stay focused on the moment. Take care of the things you can control. And we'll live with the results after, you know? So we just keep our heads down, trust one another, and look to play a complete game.
You guys listen and are very coachable. And thank you for tuning in to the NBA on Sports. For Kenny Smith, Shaquille O'Neal, Kevin Harlan, and the entire 2K Sports group, this is Bernie Johnson. We'll see you next time. And the time after that.
Like a shaft. That's it. One more answer, and I'm out. Western Conference All-Star voting. Okay. I'm still behind Steph. I just have to beat LeBron and Steph. I have to worry about Giannis.